Hi, I'm Hiroshi Nagahama.
Tara Platt.
Lucky.
Funky.
Roland Keltz.
We are judges for
America's greatest.
America's greatest.
America's greatest otaku.
ムシシとかですね、デトロイトメタルシティというアニメーションの監督をさせていただきました。
日本の面白いアーティストやファッションデザイナーとかクリエイターの女の子たちを紹介するような雑誌、マガジンやウェブサイトやイベント、パーティーなどを通じていろんな活動を展開しています。
Hi, I'm Tamari. No, I'm just joking. I'm the voice actress, Tara Platt.
I'm an author of a book called Japan America, How Japanese Pop Culture Has Invaded the US. I'm a writer, journalist, essayist, and I also lecture at the University of Tokyo.
衣装をね作る、なんかホスプレの衣装を作る人はいっぱいいるけど、うん、その中でもあんなにいっぱい作って、しかもすごく自分に似合うようなお洋服作ってたのが素敵でした、
うん、歌も本当に本物と同じように歌ってたので研究していると思います。
好きだからやってみたいとか、好きだからその業界に飛び込みたいとか、そういうふうに思ってアクティブにポンと動けてしまうっていうところが、そういう感じが画面から伝わってくる。
オリジナリティがやっぱりある女の子で、例えば頭につけてる耳みたいなやつも可愛いし、お人形もすごく可愛いし、そういう風に自分がいいなと思ったものを作って形にする力がある子なんだなっていう風に思って、で彼女がオリジナルのアニメを作りたいって言っていた発言にもすごく期待しています。
There was a point where he was asked roughly how much his collection might be worthIf he were to sell it, and unprompted, he said, "Well, I would never sell this." He knows how much it's worth, and it's worth so much more than the financial value, because it's so close to his heart, it's embedded. That to me is a level of mania, maniacal love and obsession that defines otaku.
自分が好きなジャンルっていうのも、もう明確にあって、で。明確だからこそ自ら同人誌で漫画を書いて、もっと逆に彼らのような情熱を実は俺たちが一番持たなきゃいけないのかなとはちょっと思いましたね。
もともと例えば漫画とかアニメが好きで、その漫画に描かれている日本の女の子たちのファッションだったり、いろんなそこに流れているような音楽だったりっていうのにもすごく深く興味を持ってくれて、で幅広く日本のカルチャーとしてファンになってくれてるところにすごく感動しました。本人もすごく可愛いし ね。
Today, unfortunately, I have to tell 18 people that they did not win, and I have to tell you that you did not win as well.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry about that.
Got it.
Okay.
Okay.
Yes, but don't be bummed out because you did great.
Aw, okay.
I understand.
No, I appreciate you giving me a call.
Hey, thanks again. I mean, I really appreciated the opportunity. I thought it was a lot of fun.
But yeah, no, thanks and everything for like choosing me to be part of this and stuff.
頑張ってね。
はい、ありがとうございます。
この人とどこかでと思って、多分自分はお会いしてるなと思って見ていたんですよね。そしたらサインが出ていて、あれもしかしたら俺のがあるんじゃないかなと思って見て、そしたらちゃんと飾ってくれてたんで、あ、やっぱりお会いした人だったんだと思って。
Clearly she's passionate. I mean, she has an extensive knowledge of this culture and the manga and the artists, and she was very focused on the original creators and Japan.
全体を見てアニメ業界が全部が盛り上がるようにもっとグッズを買いたいっていう風に思ってるところとか、本当にアニメの世界全体がすごく大好きなんだなっていうのに、その愛情の深さを感じました。
I think someone who not only collects but seeks out the personalities, the artists behind the work, that impresses me, the degree to which you want to know who's actually makingthe material that you love. Gina impressed me in that way.
自分たちの作品を好きで自分たちの色紙を集めてくれて自分たちのところにサインに並んでくれるのはものすごく嬉しいんだけれどもプラス何か受け取ったものを何か別の形で出してくれたりとかそういうのをもっと見たいなとは思いましたね。
家族全員が同じ趣味を持てるっていうことがまずすごく羨ましいしハッピーなことだし
食卓で多分同じアニメの話したりとかみんなブリーチの話とかできちゃうんだろうなとか
When they went into Celine's room, you know, it was quite clear she had an enormous library of manga. I think at one point she pulls out a receipt from her latest trip to the shop and it's in the thousands of dollars or a thousand something dollars. And soI don't mean it's about spending money, but clearly the obsession goes beyond simple superficial fandom and dressing everybody up and wearing costumes. But she's really out there getting the manga, reading the manga. She really loves the story, she loves the artwork, she loves the craft. So all of that I thought was impressive and astonishing in a way.
I was very impressed that she has been basically an otaku since she was a baby. I mean, she said something in her interview about even at two, her mom gave her, I forget what it was it a Hello Kitty or some sort of toy? And from then on out, it has been otaku for her all the way. And you can see the effect that it's had both on her and her sense of confidence and her sense of well-being and her family.
I didn't get a strong sense, I guess, of aesthetic obsession.You know, something really specific and keen that you could hone in on. And maybe it's a matter of her, you know, finding better ways of expressing that. I just didn't get a clear sense of that in the video interview. I couldn't grab onto something.
DC Anime Club っていうんでしたっけ?こんなに日本には面白い文化があるんだっていうのを分かってもらうために活動すべきだみたいなことをそれはすごいことだなと思って
なんか私の中のオタクっていうのはなんかそのアニメのことを何でも知ってるっていうのがオタクと思ってたんですけど彼は自分が知ってるだけじゃなくてイベントを開いたりカニバルでやったりパーティーでやったり
What's impressive about Christopher to me is the extent to which he wants to spread the gospelthat missionary zeal that he has and gathers people together. He formed the club there in Washington, D.C., which is the anime club in Washington, D.C.
He was very passionate about sharing this idea of otaku culture with others. And that really stood out to me as, you know, maybe perhaps what makes a good otaku or perhaps even America's greatest otaku is this idea of somebody that not only has a passion and enjoys...that culture themselves, but somebody who would also want to share that with others. So that really stood out to me.
Christopher, I have to tell you that you won.
Wow! Really? Oh my god! Oh my god!
Yep.
Really?
Congratulations.
Oh wow.
I'm calling you from Tokyo right now, and we're going to have you come out here pretty soon and enjoy yourself for a week.
Oh, yeah. Cool.